49ers in Wakeville. Anthony Lopez is in the building right now. I'm still amazed by his beautiful eyes and his perfect skin. I want him to explain how he has this perfect skin. As some of you may know, or you might not know, he is the CEO of Alpha Male Cosmetics. It's a male makeup line.
Yes, yes. Talk about that because
you know, we some lesbians over here.
We don't wear makeup.
I don't know nothing about makeup. Let alone old makeup. So school we need to school me. He has a few products in front of us. He's gonna break these down, like what they are, what they do. So tell us your name. I want to hear your name, how you say it.
Ooh.
What's up, everybody? This is
What's up, guys? So it's actually Anthony Lopez.
Antonio.
So funny story about that. So my actual name is Antonio, right? It's my dad's name.
Okay.
And Tony for short.
That's cute. I like how you say that. Say that again.
You need to put a dash in the middle of Ant and then Tony. So you, and I'm like, oh, Antony.
Right. I'm really happy. Thanks for having me here, guys.
It's a pleasure. Dope. No, thank you for coming through.
So my skin is flawless. Yeah.
Yeah.
My makeup line, Alpha Male Cosmetics, the first full line of makeup formulated for guys.
So this is the first
full line.
Full line.
So we're talking.
So what's
about
a full line?
Primer, foundation, BB cream, liquid concealer.
Yo, you're moving fast. calm down. Yeah, I don't even know what a BB cream is.
Right, what is that? I'm just sitting here like,
What?
Okay.
You don't gotta break down each one, but at these products.
So basically, I have primer, right? Mm-hmm. And BB cream.
What is a BB cream?
So it's like a tinted moisturizer. So it's like a lotion, right? So it's for the everyday, on-the-go kind of guy. Squeeze it in your hand, put it in your face, look a little handsome, wash your hands, go.
Okay.
Right? Primer, it's before you put on the makeup, you primer on, it just sets the makeup from going into your skin, your pores. Liquid foundation, all for people. Actors, models, you know, they want to go to an event, they put this on and make them look fresh. And then the powder is just to cover it up in terms of base.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. All right.
So, I didn't even know there was that much going into a face. Like,
right.
Yeah.
I thought it was just foundation.
Online because my girlfriend probably got all this stuff and I don't even know nothing about it.
So is there a difference between male cosmetics and female cosmetics? Or is it,
it's just a formulation. It took me about 3 years, met with a chemist, and did some.
Okay, so great. Tell me, I want to know, how did this start? Like, did you wake up one day and say, you know what, I want to make...
No, never in a million years.
What happened? Tell us the process. Like, how did come out with this?
Process. About 4 years ago, I used to model, right?
Mm-hmm. See, you need to keep on doing
as you should.
Right? I used to model, but I stopped because I broke out in the show, and it was like bad. It was like really bad. So I went to a dermatologist, and he was like, "What are you wearing on your face? Like, are you allergic?" And I was like, "I'm just wearing like CoverGirl, Revlon." He's like, "Don't wear that." I'm like, "Okay." So then I like started doing research, and I was like, "Is there anything for me for the everyday guy?" Because I love makeup, I love skincare, like clearly you guys can see. But overall, like for me, it was like little things, like, but it wasn't like something that I can say, okay, well, I'm gonna buy everything from one person.
Right.
So I did research and I was like, you know what, maybe I should do something for us guys. And I did.
And the light bulb went off in your head.
It did, but it wasn't called Alpha Male. It was so crazy.
What was it called?
How'd that come
about? In the beginning process, it was actually called Pretty Boy. You know, because everyone used to be like, you're so pretty. I'm like, okay.
Told you. Told you.
And about a year and a half into it, I was like,
I don't want to be pretty boy anymore.
Because I started growing, getting older, and I'm like, I'm a man, like, you know, macho. Like, I'm the oldest out of seven, you know.
Seven.
Yeah. How old are you?
I'm 32.
Wow, that makeup is good.
Well, this is actually good skin too.
That's good genes.
Natural. Okay.
This is like, you know, a little bit of sun. But I was laying in bed. It was so funny. I tell this story every time. Laying in bed and I was watching the like National Geographic, and it was like a pack of wolves and the guy is the alpha and the girl is the beta. And then it just hit me. I was like, oh my God, like alpha, like strong man. And I was like, that's the guy I want to target. And then I just got a trademark and I don't see for the name, and I was like,
so you just went, you just was like, this is what I'm gonna do.
This is it.
So all that's like American made, like you just.
No, this was actually a manufacturing company in Canada.
Oh.
Yeah. So.
Ooh. Did you come up with the name first, and then the product, or you already had the product and came out with the name?
So the product was already made. I just didn't have a logo. I didn't have a name. It was pretty.
Okay,
boring.
So take me to there. Like, so how did you do that? Like, do you like how? What is the beginning process to come up with making?
Research, yes. Of course. Research. Okay. You got to find out what chemicals go into making product. How do you make product? Manufacturing companies, chemists, things like that.
So you what? So yeah, you just have to go and look for people who were involved.
And then I went to Canada, Toronto, and met with a chemist there. And we just sat down and brainstormed. I was like, so we need to do some legal stuff. attorneys, contracts, and yeah.
And then it went from there.
And then it went from there, and now.
And they came up with the casings and the packaging, mm-hmm. the name on there.
Well, they're a pretty big manufacturing company. They house a lot of different brands. So I was just like, I want them to be my house. And yeah, now this was actually, it took me about 2 years to actually decide to launch it, because I was like, scared.
Right, that's always a scary process.
But now it's here.
The best things, that brings me back to one of my favorite quotes. The best things are on the other side of fear.
Yeah.
Like, oh my God, that reminds me of this video that Will Smith actually did. If you're ever on Will Smith's page, yeah.
Man, that man is a genius.
Motivational speech about that. Genius, but yeah. I digress. Keep going.
Proceed. Yeah, but carry on. I think that I'm actually like, oh my God, this is the first ever. So it's like makes everything so much more like better because it's, you know, you hear about lines
like
but,
Tom Ford has some stuff.
But this is like an actual
full, like
you have everything. Here, so what do you like, what do you see the future for this? Like, do you want a store? Do you want
You know what? The reason why I decided I didn't do this to be famous. I didn't do this mm-hmm. to be rich. Of course you want to be successful, don't get me wrong, that comes with like, the territory. I did it to open up a conversation, just basically saying, why is it not okay for men to look good? Everyone's
right.
So stereotypical.
And why is it not okay for even, because like, why is it not okay for guys to wear makeup? Because that's already the first step,
exactly.
Even opening, you have to at least open mm-hmm. that door. And it's like, when people, that's a conversation people probably don't want to have, a lot of people don't want to have.
Exactly.
You know, why, like,
it's considered feminine,
right,
it's
like,
for women. And,
like, guys are not supposed to wear makeup. Like, I know you probably heard that 100 times and time again.
Uh-huh.
You know?
You think it's going to... Straight people could wear it too.
I personally don't have a problem.
That is my target market, don't get me wrong. But I honestly, where I'm at now, the future is going to be happy. Like, I would love a store. Mm-hmm. I'm getting into that. Fragrance, perfumes, like
ooh.
Doing some women stuff with the man. But the focus
like
right now is just breaking the conversation.
Yes.
Like, making it transparent to people, like, it's okay. Like, if your girl can look good, then why can't you? Right? What's the problem, right?
You don't gotta be
life.
In a mirror with your eyes.
No, exactly.
Like, you know, some people can appreciate those women who wear like light makeup that's more of a natural feel. And it's like the same thing with guys. Some guys want to just like cover up certain things or make
I'm not saying I'm throwing this at a guy's face and be like, you should wear this. I'm not saying that. I'm saying, hey, like, there's a product on the market that will make you. My tagline is enhance your handsome. That's all I want to do. I want to take you from looking good to extra better. I want that confidence from being like 10 to 20 when you step out your door. Like, there's
and
no reason.
All kind of tones.
All shades. I got from the whitest to the whitest to the darkest to the darkest.
That's what's up.
You're gonna ring a lot of bells with this.
Oh, I have.
Like, you're gonna people.
Right. So like, is it strictly for men? Like, what if a girl comes up like,
yeah, for now,
really,
yeah.
Like, good makeup. I wanna like wear it too.
Don't get me wrong. Like, a female can put it on, right? But we have two different kind of skins. You're a little bit more softer.
This is why
men are a little more tough. We have facial hair, things
right,
like that.
Right.
So, you know, you might be allergic to it, it might break out. But I mean, you could wear
it's
it.
Like, some guys
will
break out.
But
so, did I have anything like, being that it's for men? Was that a hassle when you came down to like trying to figure out how to do
the formulation?
Yeah, like,
yeah. There's something in here that I can't talk about. That's why it's made for men. So, yeah. So yeah, no, you know, I'm not trying to give all my secrets away. I've been getting so much. It's been doing so good, and the responses of the people that are buying it are straight guys.
So it's doing well. Yeah, and you said you launched when?
April. And
of this year.
Think about it, 4 years You're later, moving. I had to. I was like, you know what, like, it gotta happen. I got a full-time job. Like, I work a 9 to 5 Monday through Friday.
Okay.
And I do this right after work. So sometimes I'll go to sleep like 2, 3 in the morning to wake up at like 7.
I know how it is.
Right.
Right.
Right. No sleep. I'm gonna go to sleep and wake up I have more orders.
And this, basically, that's what I do. I've been working on just putting everything together. I have great friends who are in the industry who have been like, they helping with my website. Shout out to Richard. Shout out to, you know, my friend Chris. They have been like, just helping me with the beauty marketing aspect. But overall, like, I had to bust my behind at my day job, make a lot of money, and then put it into the business.
Right, that's like,
was it a lot?
$20,000 so far.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's a bad.
I mean,
I've made half of it.
So,
you know.
Man, this man is moving, y'all. Get him while it's hot.
Imagine when moving. December comes. Like,
yeah, whoa. We have a lot of holiday things planned. I'm shooting videos. It's a lot happening. I'm still in the air. Like, I'm still like, wow. Because it's, I don't know. I'm waiting to actually break a little bit more with these guys who are still doing these videos with, like, CoverGirl and their mom and putting lashes on, and I'm trying to get them over to be like, hey, like, just look good, right? I get it, you're showcasing to women because you're a beauty expert, but
right.
Do this, like, this is your guy, you know?
I'm happy for you because you about to open up some doors, and you never know who come behind you. Like, you might open a door for somebody.
Everybody, mama, like, now gonna want to come out with a whole line of male cosmetics.
Right.
It's gonna be something else, and it's like, I already know the person.
I'm good legally, so don't try it. Have your
lawyers talk to his lawyers, because you're not about to be doing all of that.
You crack that whip real quick. Try it.
But I was going to say, you already been popping. Didn't you say you were?
I've done a lot of stuff, yeah.
Right, so I can't even say I'm mind blown, because it's like, I don't want to say it's expected either, but it's just that when I first time I ever met this guy, I was like, he's going to be something. I don't know what it is.
She did say that.
He has star quality.
It's like something's going to happen where he's going to be hot. I don't know what it is.
I don't want to be a star, though. I want to be
known
for things like changing. This. I want to make change. That is my goal, and that's what I'm doing. But I've done a lot. Like, I've written a book.
What?
Yeah.
Man. I mean, we could be here all. I mean,
I've just done a lot.
He's done everything.
I don't say.
Yeah, no. But this is where I'm at, and I think just going forward, this is just where I want to stay. Like, this.
So this is it. You just want to take this and run with it.
This is it.
And you just want to break off the other things, like you said, stores and
fragrance and clothes,
and you can have your own modeling.
Yeah, I have models.
You'll probably have a commercial.
I'm working on a commercial now.
Wow. He's already two steps ahead.
I'm doing things because I have people that are like so supportive. Like, my family, man, like.
Shout out to the fam.
Shout out to my family. I love you guys.
La familia.
My friends, like, you know, one of my friends here, Maria, she's here. And she's like,
Hey, Maria.
She had a busy day, and she was like, hey, I want to go see your radio thing. And I was like, come on. Like, friends like that are like, you know, I have friends and family listening now. Love you guys. You know.
Hey, what's up, friends and family?
Hey, everybody. Hey, but it's kind of like, you need to be surrounded with people that are going to push you.
And also tell you the truth.
Like, Maria literally be like, no, not going to happen. Don't do that. Like, but at the end of the day, this is why I keep going. And I'm like, you know what? I got to outdo myself. I got to be better than yesterday. And it's paying off, man.
And since you talk about friends and family, you got a special somebody in your life? Like
a fiance?
Oh! Funk like funk.
Dang, he's been shutting it down all night. He don't even let me get the question out. Like, bam, shut it down. Nope, fiance. That ain't my boo thing. That ain't my side piece. That ain't nothing. That's my fiance. Wow, yeah, congratulations.
2.5 years.
2.5 years. Leah. How did that come about?
We met online and.
Shout out to online daters.
Online dating.
We be hitting the jackpot out here.
Online dating.
Shout out your social network you use.
Oh, Jack?
Jack?
Shout out to Jack.
Woo! Jack, okay, that's a new one.
Yeah, that was intense. It was normally on Jack, they'd be trying to just, you know, have sex.
I was waiting for you to say Tinder or something, because I knew it wasn't POS.
Tinder wasn't popping back then. Mm-hmm. Like, this was like about 3 years ago, so it's different now. But,
yeah. I know, dude, Tinder had its wave, though. It had this little, like,
He's been very, very, very supportive, and
Does that is it easy to maintain a business as the business you have and maintain the relationship?
It was hard, the beginning process, because all I did was go to work. I came home. I did.
He's probably
makeup
like,
line, and I'm like, oh man, I forgot I have a
3 o'clock in the morning thing.
Sorry about that. But. At the end of the day, I'm supportive, so like sweaty.
He's good,
still beautiful.
You got any haters?
I don't believe in haters. I believe that those are people that are just motivating you to do better.
You lose your friends?
Watching your friends? Those are the spectators.
I lost a lot of friends. I did.
Why do you think so?
I don't know. I feel like, my life has just shifted, you know, more like working and entrepreneur. Most people just want to go to the club every day. Don't get me wrong.
Talk about it.
Chris has been going out with me, like,
Maria. I know exactly but how you feel.
Some people would want to do that every day. I got stuff to take care of.
Right.
And then you also grow. Like, a couple of friends went into the drag world. I'm like, oh, that's not my life, so let me go this way. But I wish her nothing but success and blessings.
Right. Yeah, I like that. Shout out to the haters. He loves you.
Love you guys.
Do you think it's going to be harder for you to just you being a homosexual male?
I like gay. I don't like that.
Gay. As a gay man.
As a gay man.
Right. As a gay man. Do you think it's going to be hard for you to push this product in that industry?
No.
Not at all.
So all my clients. Excuse me, customers. I don't want to say clients. I don't even know what that means. Mm. But all my customers have been straight men. Mm. Yeah.
So you're rich.
You know why? You know why I think that is? Is because, like, you know, the straight men who do want to wear makeup, they know exactly who to go to. Like, if I was a straight man, I would
like, probably falling in love with his ass. I need some man to find. I mean, y'all have been on the DL for a long time, but this man is looking real good right now.
Or like, that's the thing. When you be like, yo, he looks real good, yo, and if he's wearing makeup, I want to look. If you want to look as good as him, you got to do what he do.
What's funny is I'm not wearing a lot, though. I'm only wearing, like, primer, this, and concealer.
It's light, like I said, it enhances. Is it enhancement? It's not really about covering anything up or trying to, like,
so the dykes can't
your face.
Sorry, guys.
What about the trans?
The thing about that is that's where the conversation is going to be a little bit more
controversial. Yes, it is, because you're going to have a trans like, yeah, but I want to wear the alpha male costume.
At the end of the day, you got to think about, you also got to think about what men have in their testosterone.
Right.
So that.
And no matter what you take, women are going to have
trans women do.
Right. So
trans men, excuse me.
Trans men. So yeah, you take the T, you should be able to use it, right?
Yep.
So you have to be all the way on T. You can't just be like, yeah, I'm trans, but really not going through.
Mm-hmm.
That's gonna get hot. It's gonna be a battle, like, for real. That's gonna be crazy. Yeah. But yeah, as a gay man in the makeup world, it's gonna be.
I don't think there's no competition for you, honestly. I'd be like, yo, you in there.
No, there's no competition.
You're in
there. That's what I'm saying. The door is open for you to conquer it all.
I mean, I'm sure that once this picks up more, I'm going to have bigger companies trying to knock me down.
I'll be like, you hiring?
I'm a little guy. You know?
You hiring?
At the the end of the day, like I said, I got all my legal crap together, so.
My look light, but you heavy, though.
I know, right? You know, shout out to my Instagram following.
Right. He had a lot, too. I was like, man, how did you get up there? What happened? Like, you just...
You know what's funny? I did a lot of shout outs for shout outs when I first started. So I was like, shout out for shout out.
Yo, those joints really work.
They do. I swear to God. I started off.
Who do you shout out?
I was like at 10K. And
that means start now.
I should start now?
Yeah. And hashtags too. When you hashtag.
Holla. I like the hashtags.
I gotta get on it.
You gotta get on it. That's how I became where I'm at. And now, because I've done everything.
Yeah,
like,
you got stuff going on.
I've done so much.
Yeah, because before I really heard about the Cosmans, you had like 60K. I was like, what is he doing?
Yeah.
He's so hot. Maybe that's really, really hot.
No, I'm okay. I'm an average.
But that makes me sad. He knows. Wake up in the morning like, damn, I look good.
I actually don't do that. I don't. I'm just a regular guy. Like, damn. I don't. Here's the thing. Like, I don't look in the mirror and be like, oh, damn, I'm fine. I just be like, hey, what's up?
What's up, handsome?
Your
teeth are really white.
I take care of myself.
Like, come on, your beard is nicely groomed.
Because
like,
I just dyed it. Most people don't take care of themselves. Like, again, I know a lot of guys that are so full of themselves that it just makes them look so ugly.
Right.
Like, I walk past people, I'm like, oh, you're very handsome. And they're like, thanks. And I'm like... I don't want to sleep with you. I'm just giving you a compliment, but that's how they think.
Right, because I have something to enhance you, handsome.
And their core value is just nasty. Like, I'm just a very
arrogant,
humble person.
Right.
Yeah, I feel that. That's why I vibe too. I'm like a natural hippie.
They don't make me.
Yeah, and you're like super like caring.
Humble about it.
You said you had some questions for you.
I'm holding off. I just wanted to add, before I got into that, I wanted to ask you. This is just a question I just would like to know. Do you think it's easier being a gay man now than it has ever been? Or do you think it's still hard?
That's a good question. It was harder for me back then, in the 90s. I was actually 16 when I came out.
Mm.
And I didn't want to come out. So I came out to my mom, shout out to mom. Mm. And I told her not to tell my dad. And she's like, well, I'm going to tell him, we're going to have pillow talk. And I'm like, don't tell him. Like, let me figure out if this is actually,
what's going on.
And then he came home one day and he was like, can I ask you a question? I was like, what? He pulled me to the room, closed the door. I was like, oh, he's about to kill me. Like,
oh, God.
Dead. And he was just like, are you guys? I was like, yeah. I was like, okay, I still love you. And I was like, okay. Me and him didn't talk for like five years.
After that,
like him and my mom would get into arguments and he would like throw me in there. I mean, think about him, his firstborn, he's also Spanish.
Mm-hmm.
So
wait, what's your background?
I'm Puerto Rican.
Knew it.
Italian.
Knew it.
And Palestinian.
You see, that mixture is like, hey, what? Yeah.
The Palestinian kind of threw me.
Yeah.
I'm like, whoa.
Thanks to the mama jeans.
Right.
And then we didn't really, like, it would be like a high and by, but we didn't really fully talk until I was probably like,
so 22. Your dad's the Puerto Rican one?
Yeah.
And that's just it?
Yeah.
That's why.
He's crazy.
Like, yeah, that
but
is.
Now, man, like, when I tell you now, he's
great.
Biggest supporter.
Oh.
Like when I did my launch party, I was on the red carpet. I can see it in his eyes. He was just so happy.
So proud.
Yeah.
That's the greatest feeling ever. Yeah.
It is. How
you kind of won at life. That's like you're winning at life.
Oh yeah, my brothers, my sister, my mom, like everyone in my family.
Once you won your family over, that's great. When they're supporting everything you do,
they just want to make sure I'm good and I'm happy and. I'm in that department. I'm so blessed. Like they're listening now. My parents are listening now. Trust me, my parents are real ghetto.
Yeah, I like that.
In a good way. No, but they're real.
Okay, so how did you know that you were gay?
I was like six.
Mm, what happened?
I saw this boy in class, and I was like, why do I think he's cute? And I was like a little kid.
Yeah,
I was like,
how do you know? Right.
And I had this feeling, and I was like, I don't know if this is right. But then I didn't actually start acting on it. Like, it hit me again when I was like 10. And I was like,
okay.
You know, my body starts changing. And then when I was 12, I had my first sexual experience, of course, with a girl, and I was like, blah.
Right, so you had that nookie nookie.
Yeah, I had that nookie
nookie. You was like, nah.
I was like, no bueno, no thank
no,
you.
No, damn, you and turned away the
what you like, exactly.
Right.
But like, I was 13, I had my first, like, little kiss with one of my old best friends. I ain't gonna tell you what it is. And then I was 16. I had my first relationship, my first boyfriend. He was older too. He was like 21. We dated for like 3 years, and he just taught me everything.
Taught you everything? How?
Taught me like
how to begin.
No, like sexual.
You can't teach that, yo.
That's
what I'm
like
saying.
That.
How do you? Okay, so.
Oh, when I came out, I was flaming.
See, that's what I was gonna, that was gonna be my next question. Because I feel like everybody, is it cliche or not that like gay men go through that really, really flamboyant, like, I need to know what's going on phase?
I feel like people that are in the closet, they have all this like repressed, like, it's just like in there and they just don't want
to
show.
I like to call it glitter.
Oh, glitter.
Yeah.
And then
you're like,
you come out, it's like, you're just like showing it. So
it,
I would like, I would wear the tightest jeans. I wore like the shirts tied up. I had long black hair. I wore lip gloss. Like, I wanted to show my tramp stamp all the time. I was like, it was so bad.
I went to school with somebody who had a similar story, and you remind me of him so much. But it's so crazy because you guys grew like, oh my god.
I think it's opposite for gay girls because I went through my hard.
I was trying to find me, and I did, and I was like, okay, I don't have to be super gay to be it. Gay.
So would you consider yourself a title, like a top or a bottom?
Oh, I don't do titles. I'm Tony.
Okay. Shout out to the no labels. I like
I don't do labels.
How come?
Just I don't. I'm a guy. I like a guy. That's it.
Like, that's how I
so
like.
So you don't
to
go
be
judging
too.
Like, oh, I only like tops. Oh, I only like bottoms.
No, that's so cliche, and it's just like everyone. Don't get me wrong. People like what they like, but to be in a very healthy relationship long term you need to be versatile. I'm sorry,
right?
Because if you don't give me what I'm asking for from a partner, then I'm gonna get it somewhere else, bottom line. And that's why I have a fiance.
That's why we had a show, you know, because in the lesbian world they're called like touch me nots, the ones that are like super,
I don't know
like
anything about that. Like,
see, that's why that's why we come along and we kind of gotta shed light on those people. Yeah,
they
because
only want to, they just want to give you the head and that's it.
They just want to do, they just want to do you and do everything.
Okay,
and that's
so,
it.
Back to life. I just can't. This is I mean,
he don't like talking about cootie bottles.
Oh, okay.
Sorry, guys.
Talking about how you not like it, just like some guys be like. How do you like? Why do you
maybe
like it? Like,
maybe
why not like it?
Maybe it's the smell. It's an acquired taste.
Have you ever tasted it before?
Mm-hmm.
You didn't like it? Mm-hmm. What's wrong with you? Why you didn't like it?
I'm a gay guy.
He's real gay.
That's
he's real
it.
Gay.
I like men. I like men. No, it was back in the day, you know.
And that was
there was
time.
Never. There
I've
was
had
never
about three, four girls.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So you, I was in relationships
enough
with girls.
Right, and you had enough and you were just like, look, this is not.
The last time I was like, oh, hell, nah.
Like, it's
that is really not happening no more, so.
And then that was it. So you're not a top or bottom, you're Tony.
Tony, yeah.
Would you consider your man a top or bottom, and he's just him?
He's just him.
He's just him. So just him and just him came together and they're just them.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's.
I like
so
that.
So you don't, so what's your, before you met your fiance, what was your type? Like, what did you go for? Like, did
you
have
your... I don't have a type.
So you didn't go for, like, more manly or
more girlier, like...
My thing is, I'm over here sweating and wiping myself, but my thing is, I'm all about energy. Mm-hmm. Like, if I come next to you and I feel your energy, mm-hmm. you know, that's how I get to know you, but I don't know. I don't go out there looking for guys either. I mean, I'm weird.
No.
Yeah, I've changed. Like, my aspect is just work. So even meeting him, it was like I was working. I was traveling from Atlanta.
Oh, did you meet him in your industry or something?
No, we're in two different industries, thank God. So
you know, men are going to be throwing themselves at you now.
They already do.
You know how hard that is?
Wow. It's not.
You don't think so?
Nope.
Loyalty, loyalty.
I like that.
It's so hard to find someone loyal.
It is.
So. You think you found him?
Yeah. Well, I take that from my mom and dad. They've been together for like 35 years. So.
Wow.
It's they've been through their stuff. Mm-hmm. And to see them just where they are now, I'm like, I believe in it. Unconditional love. Yeah, that's real. So no, I don't, it doesn't faze me. Like, I don't, yeah. I'm like, okay, yeah, well, thanks.
Right? So what if it's like just a fine, he just one fine, I don't know.
And
it's
he's
like
gonna be just that, one
and he
fine,
just like,
know.
Yo, what's up? What's up, Aunt?
I was out.
You don't ever get a craving for that snack?
Nope.
Never. For a little midnight snack?
Nope.
You don't ever get a craving?
No.
You don't ever get to dip in that over there, like,
No.
That's a happy man right there.
He's got his job. Disciplined.
Yo.
He is conditioned.
Listen, I come
that
from
is
a conditional love family. I'm
fully
working,
man.
And I got what I
that's
want.
That's what you focus on. You
yeah,
have
I don't need... Oh, he
ladies and happy. Gents, here we have a fully groomed man.
Yes, that's
he's
me.
He's fully groomed.
Fully groomed man.
That makes me feel good.
Yeah. there's people like me out there.
Like,
you know?
Where you find them? Where is there more?
Because there's a lot of stereotypes that, like, you know, gay men just be
all out.
They
there.
All out there. They all over the place.
I can say
like,
the same thing about Leslie.
Right.
Don't get me wrong.
You can, but us lesbians looking from the gay world, from the outside.
Yeah, I like how he called it. You gotta call us Leslies from now.
Leslies.
I like Leslies.
I'm a Leslie.
Yeah. I don't like butch and femme and dyke.
Yeah,
like,
me too. That's not cute.
You
Leslie.
Guys are Leslies.
Yeah. Just like us, when people ask us, oh, what do you consider yourself a stud?
I'm gonna be like, next time somebody asks me, I'm like, I'm a Leslie.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm a
you figure it out. You figure it out.
But no, yeah, I mean, I'm just happy where I'm at now.
So you're not worried about none of this?
No. Work.
I'm ready to see him when he gets super famous. When he just, like, he can't even get out his car. Everybody's like,
and I'm going to still have Maria recording videos for me. I'm going to still have
She's going to be running a production crew. She's going to be like, all right, he needs his photos here. He needs to
make
it here.
Makeup.
She'll
make up all his
you
nose.
Y'all going to sign your contract. She's going to be in charge of all the video footage. You got to bring a team with you.
I'm getting my team together, manager, publicist. It's happening.
Right.
Send that elevator back down.
Alpha milk.
And it's dope that these
know?
People are like, they're not out here trying to, like, yeah, I need you to give me some money if I'm going to do this. I'm going to need you to give me this.
I've actually gotten a lot of people say, hey, send me some free samples. And I'm like,
already? I've been like, already?
You need to purchase. You know, think about it this way. Like, we're so, this goes back into what I was talking about earlier. Like, people are so quick to support someone else who's famous and make them more million than support someone who's actually
like,
trying
talk
to come
about
up.
It. Talk
you know
about
like,
it.
Why are you going to CoverGirl to still buy the concealer when you know there's a makeup line for men on the market?
Because people are going
to
hate.
Because at the end of the day, you don't want no one new to succeed because you hate it on yourself in your life. Sorry, I get real into it.
It's
real.
Let him know.
I wish you could preach that sermon right now.
You know what I'm saying? Like, for me, it's been very, like... I've had people reach out to me like, hey, send me some samples. I'm like, I don't have samples. Okay, well, I would love to collaborate.
Buy my product and let me know.
Like,
everybody want to collaborate.
www.alphamelcosmetics.com. You can go there.
Right.
And purchase your makeup. Like, at the end of the day, like, it's all about supporting. Like, if I see someone, like, I'm always that guy. If I see someone, like, selling hats and shirts and stuff like that, like... Mm-hmm. My friend at work, she was doing like a fraternity clothing line. Mm-hmm. I was like, I'm gonna buy a sweater. Like, I bought a sweater. I'm like, here, like, I have the money. $35 is not expensive. You're my friend. I'm gonna support you.
Right. That's the thing. I always say that too. Like, if your friends are in a position to put you on and they don't, or nobody supports you, that's not your friend.
Mm-hmm.
It's not your friend.
Mm-hmm.
Yo, that was shade to somebody. Whoever listened, that was shade to somebody.
Yeah. Don't come along. Yeah, exactly. That goes for everything. Because either way, you selling cosmetics, you selling anything, you performing a service of any sort, even that, even for everybody, anything that you do, if you out here, your friends know that you're doing this, and they still ask you to give them free shit, I mean, free stuff.
I'm passionate,
but
it's true.
If they're still asking for free stuff, asking you to do them a favor, trying to cut you short somehow, don't do it. That's not your friend.
They don't support you. Personally, like, I'm all about supporting people who I don't know, trying to make a change just in their life in general. I've hung around with a lot of people, and we go in different directions because people are, you know, thriving, and I'm always the person to reach out and be like, yo, I support you. I know you're busy, but I support you, no matter what, you know? But you guys actually brought me on, you know, and for me, that's big, right?
Yeah. So, like, for us, it's like, yo, we the first full line.
Yes. And that's the thing.
Get that straight.
And I'm getting that.
We try to bring and shed light on everybody who's doing something. Everybody who deserves notoriety for what they're doing. You're not just anybody out here just trying to do it just because.
Yeah.
We support that. We want everybody to know that if you're doing something, you have something you're working on, we want you to come on Savage Sunday and talk about it also. You know? Let us find out how you can. But at the same time, we want to thank you, for coming.
Yes. Is there anything nice you want to say to your fiance?
Besides, I love you.
Besides, I love you.
Thank you for being very supportive and understanding.
And I want to see you when I get home. So. what's the best part you like about him? Like, what is the characteristic about him that just got
what's
you?
His best quality?
Yeah.
He's sweet.
Aww.
And caring. Yeah.
And what is it about him that just makes you want to rip your clothes off?
His heart.
Yeah, I'm tired of all of this good stuff. Give me the juice. I want to know, like, does he got a big
tailor?
Is he cut up? Like, is his face? Oh, he tatted up.
He got it.
Whoa. So he tatted up. So it's beautiful. He's talking about headphones right now, so I'm like, wait, huh? But we're happy that you came.
Thank you so much. You made our night.
I'm so happy that you finally came through up in here.
Right.
At me, Antonio_Lopez.
Drop your tags.
AlphaMoreCosmetics.com. Gentlemen, hit me up.
Enhance your handsome. Savage Sundays, Savage T, Hot, I want to say Hot 97, dang. Shout out to Hot 97 and all of them. Nonfiction, WCYE 95.9 FM Radio. We'll see y'all.
Next week, same time, same place. Shout out to Nonfiction Radio.
Thanks for coming through, sexy. Oh, he gave me a wink. See y'all later, guys.
Have a good night.
Woo! That's hot. Oh my God, it's hot. My ears are like.
Anxiety.